All right, this is an electric motor repair. This was a scrapyard find. This is going to be a real good impact wrench when I get it going. 7.5 amp. So good sized motor in there. Had a crack right here. My theory here, I used the plastic welder, but my theory is that if I use the PVC, this is the first time that I've used the PVC primer, and I put the PVC primer on and then the epoxy welder. I scratched it up with this Dremel. I'm thinking I'll get a better seal there. The wire was cut, so I've got that ready to redo. I think the main problem with this was the everything in the motor looks good. The bearings seem good. They turn freely. But the main problem here is the poor condition of the brushes. And so it looked like both of them had been disconnected. One of them had a spring that was compressed and had lost its springiness, so I just pulled it back out again. So if I can't find a similar brush, then I'm going to probably find a way to get that back in there and make a connection. I can't use the metal welder or the plastic welder because it doesn't make continuity. I did buy a glue at one point that's supposed to keep contact and continuity, and even super glue will stop the flow of current. So what I might even do is, if I have to use this, just stuff in some copper wire or something like that, just so that it stays in place. Here's the other one too, if you can see it right there. So I think we'll get this going, and it will make a good electric impact wrench. Yeah, make it handy to where I don't have to take the air compressor around all the place. All right, I just bought 20 replacement brushes from China for $2.60. 6 millimeter, 10 millimeter, 15 millimeter. But I'm gonna go ahead and try to make these work. All right, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this copper wire right here, which is comes out of the fluorescent lights, the single strand. I'm gonna strip it. Now that one fits pretty good in there. It's pretty snug. So I might actually put some glue up on top since it's got a good. I think I'm just gonna try to make sure it's good and clean. Well, there. It came off. So now I can definitely work on. But I need to get the spring around there. It's going to make it harder. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Yeah, because if I don't get that spring around there now. I'm... I might end up using solder. I think I'll use solder. All right. I ended up putting a little computer screw in there. And it's a pretty good fit, so I'm gonna try it on the other one. Cleaning it, it's kind of, this is the one that was compressed together. Something had melted. Into it. When I get it a little bit more shiny. This one looks like it had gotten hot. See if it's in there. Looks like it. I can try to tighten it up. All right, we'll see if we get a good enough contact in there now. I'd say so. This one's better. Didn't want to seem to spin. There. Try to tighten it again. Something about this one, if I tighten it too much, it doesn't want to spin. I don't want to do it too tight. I'll leave it about like that. It's spinning pretty good. Forward, reverse. This is really hard now, so I think that's a good fix. Put the top back on. Hook up the wire. Took out too much of the insulation. Don't need the brown. Whoop. Into that. Wire nuts. it's kind of small. Hope I have enough room in the room. Yeah, I do. Plenty of room. Powerful. Can't wait to use it. All right, good fix.